know you accidentally attacked on Friday, you know, saying that you was thinking about putting your 2-week notice in, and you know, so where are you with things?
I was fine. The only thing I had to do, the only thing I had to do was even when I had to do with you and then after what happened to my family, they said, yo, I don't mind. They hear it as much as I can, as much as I can, just that on Saturday, you know, I need to be off by like 2 o'clock in the morning.
Do you need Friday off too?
I don't need any day off. I just need to be off by
like
Monday. And I'm going to be off by like Monday.
Yeah,
that's all I need.
But you're getting ready for the members only, right?
Yeah, once Aramis come, he'll be one of the members only.
Anderson worked it out, so it's not an issue.
Okay. But now, was he a server or a cook?
It was really just a conversation. I had with him. He was like, I apologize. It was just a misunderstanding.
You know, in this type of environment, it's something that you got to get adapted to. And these, like, some of these young boys around here, they just don't have the right
mindset. They hot heads.
They hot heads.
Well, that was to make sure he wasn't going to make good on his breath.
A lot of them talk. 99.9% of them just be talking.
Yeah.
Like, we had one that worked here a little bit before you got here. You know, he was just way too reckless. Gave him a lot of chances and messed around trying to break it. He threatened me too. He ain't tell me directly, but he was telling people indirectly that he was gonna come shoot me. But he was crying like a baby, literally. Tears coming down his eyes when I let him go.
I think, you know, it'll be a good idea to get us like a little shift lead or floor manager or something like that as well. So I definitely got that in the budget, you know, for us to do so. So let's, you know, after a couple of weeks, you know, move forward with that as well. So I'm going to let you go ahead and start your meeting off and just kind of update me on anything that you want to.
I spoke to Hugh about it. I thought he was going to be here. And the only people I'm really having a problem with is June and Mike. They are, and that's why I've been at the door so much, they're selling sections. But my thing is, we're not getting any of that. We're not getting cut in on this money. And like, it's just not adding up and making sense to me, because you're turning in $120, $130 at the end of the night, and you're selling $2,000 or $3,000 sections, charging people $2,000 or $3,000. I found this out. Mace, the old cook, comes up and was like, had asked me how much a bottle was. And so Mace reached out to Courtney. So Courtney was there as well. We both were there. So reached out to Courtney and was like, Courtney, like, what the fuck? They're trying to charge me $500 for a bottle. Amos told me a bottle was $260 because, you know, she told me what she wanted. So I looked up, gratuity, everything. $260. So she's like, they're trying to charge me.
So going forward, they can't sell any sections. All of the sections come to us.
Okay.
We will refuse to sit their people and refuse to give them bottles.
Okay.
If they want to sell sections, they give them to us and we'll set them up.
Okay.
They making more than we're making.
For the night, they making more than we making on the whole night.
That
kind of led me into the next one, because the door money business has been extremely low. So what I'm seeing for the people that
we need to pay somebody to sit right there with them.
Okay.
So just like how we was doing, you know, like how Evie had a Tierra, you know, sitting there at the door and all that, we need to pay somebody to sit right there at the door.
He didn't want to try to ruffle more feathers, so he wanted to know like how important is their business to us, as far as doing, you know, these out loud parties with them. Are they that important? Because if there's an issue, we can start moving up the door and everything directly.
The money is important, but it don't have to be. We don't have to do after hours with them. We can do it with somebody else.
I think the in-house, this organization is what's effective. But he said that he think he got a solid team back to living.
So we'll see how I go the next couple of weeks. Yo, so once again, let you guys join me on my Monday morning meetings. Hey, I just got back off vacation, fresh off vacation. Right back at it, man. When you sign up for this life, you sure better be ready for it. So I just finished having, number one, my corporate meeting with my director of operations, Mr. Bentley Didier. We reviewed and recapped on everything I missed while I was out of town. We talked about the Snoop Hefner pool party that's coming up July 25th. We talked about the charity events that we've got coming up. We've talked about everything from Escobar downtown all the way down to members only. After that, I did my manager's meeting with my Escobar downtown staff, and we talked about our food costs, our alcohol costs, our sales. We talked about our growing business, our growing crowd here. Then I moved into my manager's meeting at members only. We talked about our after hours business. We talked about our events. And we talked about our new kitchen that we're going to be renovating and have coming. So always working here at Dillard Hospitality Group, always trying to make sure that our venues can provide the best customer service and bring in the most dollars as far as revenue, and just keep the culture that we have here so we have an enjoyable place for our managers and our staff alike to work at. So y'all keep following me. We're gonna head over to Crave soon, guys.
I know what you're doing.
So how was it last night with the guy?
The screen that he's switching out for is good. He's still, you know, really sweet, but he knows his job. Right? He's always outside. He asks questions. If he has a question about it, like he's like, what age did he be? 19 or 21. So he's very on it. The other guy, I don't really know what his issue was. I think he was just trying to be more in the mix than being doing his job. Being here that night, I told him prior that Friday, I was like, are you working or are you playing? Because, I'm over here.
And then, so when Cap says the invoice, are we, making sure we let him know? Like, no, he wasn't here for these hours. And okay. Yes. Security is so important right now, just with it's always very important, but. You know, there's all these issues. Like, I wasn't in the city for 4th of July weekend, but it was dangerous. That shit, I'm glad I closed Hooker Highway down, because, that's exactly where that big shooting was, It's ridiculous. And then it's less police officers and stuff in the city, So it's crazy. It's like people are taking full advantage, The major maintenance issues that I have is this roof steel. So Bentley has finally been able to get some communication from them on that. And hopefully that will finally start being in the works. I know this ice machine has been acting up. Now that ice machine was bought brand new. Not even a year ago. So we may need to get back in touch with Restaurant Store. I know Bentley was saying it's kind of congested in the area that we have it. And Jasmine was mentioning that a lot of times the top is left up on it. So I don't know if maybe those couple of things have something to do with it. But we definitely need to, try to get down to the bottom of that. Because like I said, that was a brand new ice machine. Yep. What about this curbside window? Because, guys, keep in mind, for example, in Miami, they just shut everything down again. So I fully expect that, I don't know, our governor is a little different. I think that also because of the crime and stuff that we're experiencing, that may push him to do something. So we have to be, prepared for that. And that curbside window, of course, would be a huge help for us. So where are we at with the awning and the shelf and all that stuff?
Ms. Kim talked, was it Saturday, about trying to use our floor days and trying to use lots of video awning. It's not as busy in here to kind of get that going. So we're going to figure out how we can just implement that over this.
Even in Miami, they was doing that. Like, you can't go anywhere in Miami without wearing a mask. If you don't have it on for several times, they're gonna ask you to leave. So we have to start doing more of those things as well, to protect ourselves. I don't think we haven't had anybody that's tested negative here, have we? Thank God. Even just utilizing the disposable hookahs, the hookah hoses, those are things that'll help. Esco South and Esco Downtown get their freestanding sanitizer stations. I ordered them for you guys as well. Let's go ahead and get started.
I've heard that a situation happened due to the mask.
Why was that a problem that Bentley told a staff member to have on masks and gloves?
I think he felt that he should have been on too.
Who gives a fuck? Reggie, what was the issue?
And nobody gives a fuck who said it. The problem is the way that you simulated the message to the staff. I had staff members coming up complaining that was coming to him and coming to them and told like he's their superior.
Everybody needs to be wearing masks. I'm wearing a mask right now. I've been wearing a mask all day long, except for when I was in my car. And the thing is if people wear them, they will get used to them, It's something that's new, for everybody. But the more that you do it, the more you do get used to it. They may need to invest in a mask that, like one of these super masks that Bentley has on, that's got, where you can breathe a little bit better and things of that nature. But
still
Yeah, with the little filters and stuff like that. So right now we don't have, like, Ashley just had to walk to the store to get me ginger ale, bottled water, why don't we have the things that we need? Thank you, love.
Ginger ale and the boxes are full because the people just came last week, so I mean, when Billy was even killed the coach, right, ginger ale is all gone and lemonade is all done. Okay, DG water, DG water, we were from Empire, Empire is shut down. And we went to Sam's and Costco's, and they're out of DG water.
Y'all can see what's going on with that. All right, so let's kind of get into it. Updates on security. How's security been doing?
Everything has been fine. He had to pull two of the officers and send them to the other locations.
Of course, his company is kind of going through what we're all going through, you know, we're just definitely in an environment right now or in a time period where it's just even harder to find good health, especially, you know, as much money as this government is giving out, you know, for people to sit at home. But he's going to have to step it up. You know, we may have to merge security companies, you know, and do another contract with another security company, you know, because the city is just on fire as far as violence and crime. You know, we have to make sure that everybody is safe, you know. Yo, wrapping up the day, what, 6 meetings down. So we just finished up here at Esco South, talking about everything from sales to reducing food costs, all the way down to using our QR codes for our menu. We are in the midst of a pandemic, so we're going to be switching up a few things to keep our customers, our staff, and everyone around us safe and sound. We also just got in our freestanding sanitizer station, so we're looking forward to getting those up. Over at Cray, we talked about some of our maintenance issues. We talked about minimizing our menu so that we can decrease our food costs. And hey guys, we're just looking to make ourselves bigger and better so we can continue to serve you. We appreciate all of the love and support. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube, Who is Snoop? Subscribe to my IG at Who is Snoop? And hey, if you want to know my story, go on over to my website, whoisnoop.com. Appreciate it.